Southwest Stages is a nonprofit media organization which strives to advance and promote the art of live music, to celebrate cultures, and unite communities throughout the Southwest through the recording, archiving, and broadcasting of community musical events. A list of artists recorded by Southwest Stages, our broadcast schedule, and partner stations can be found on our website, southweststages.org. From the heart of the Southwest in Albuquerque, New Mexico, I'm your guest host, David House, and this is Southwest Stages.
Every moment during the show, we take the time to remind everybody in this room of the beauty that you are and all the beauty that you have within you. And we thank you for allowing us to come here and to be musicians and to do what we do and do what we love to do, to play music to people all over the world. We thank you for that. This song goes out to the people who are suffering all over the world right now, especially in a place called Iraq. A place that we think is filled with an unjust government doing some unjust things. We don't believe in this war, and we encourage you anytime you get a chance to take your time to speak out against it, because we need to bring people together, not divide them apart. So remember that beauty that you hold on within you. Remember the beauty that each and every one of you possess inside. Let me see your hands in the air. Come on, Santa Fe!
On this edition of Southwest Stages, we're celebrating our 100th show as we continue our special four-part series that takes a look back at the first 3 years of Southwest Stages programming. Tonight's show is the second in a series of four programs that will give you a behind-the-scenes look into Southwest Stages. During this four-part series, we'll showcase some of the incredible artists that have been featured during our first three seasons. Tonight's program is the second in this series and features interviews by guest host Mike Koster, who is the executive director of Southwest Roots Music, and interviews by guest host reggae expert Aija Umi, a 30-year radio veteran and DJ in New Mexico. Our guest hosts talk with John Strader, Chip Borton, and Nola Daves Moses at the Southwest Stages Studios, as they reveal intimate details of the program to our listeners and stations. During this four-part series, you'll hear music previously featured on Southwest Stages programs, and you'll get a glimpse into future broadcasts. On tonight's show, we'll continue our four-part series with music by Ozo Motley, Robert Cray, Coco Taylor, Odetta, Alvin Youngblood Hart, and Corey Harris with Henry Butler. I'm your special guest host, David House. Let's kick off the show with new music that's never been aired on Southwest Stages before. Recorded live at the Rialto Theater in Tucson, Arizona in February 2007, it's music by Latino superstars Los Lobos.
Thank you. préstame tu medicina, pajarito con curión para sacarle una espina, que tengo en el corazón, que tengo en el corazón, por eso que me lastima, dime cómo te llamas, de quererte para quererte, porque yo no puedo amarte sin conocerte de mi prenda querida. La prenda querida es la perdición de los hombres. ¿Acaso son las mujeres?
Thank you. Muchas gracias. Just want to remind you in passing, we got a CD here for sale. It's the cool thing about this CD is that it's not being sold at the stores. It's only being sold at our acoustic shows. So we got it here for sale. It's called Acoustic en Vivo Los Lobos Live. All right. Thank you. Oh, yeah, if you buy a CD, we're going to sign them here for you tonight. How about that? Yeah. Forgot about that. All right. All the way from La Huasteca, some música huasteca for you. David Hidalgo on the violin.
prepara que es una gloria, ascende, te quiero más.
Thank you. All right.
New music by Los Lobos, recorded live at the Rialto Theater in Tucson, Arizona in February of 2007. I'm your special guest host, David House, and you're listening to part two of our special four-part series celebrating Southwest Stage's 100th show. Now let's head back to the Southwest Stage's studios as Mike Koster continues his conversation with the Southwest Stage's crew.
I'd say one of the what I consider one of the best interviews and fun rapports I ever had with an artist was Ozo Motley, which was one of the crew favorites. All of us were totally obsessed with Ozo. We loved Ozo Motley. We never had a chance to.
We love Ozo Motley.
We love Ozo.
When did you record them?
That was back in, I think it was 2004. We had two nights with Ozo, which we had stated earlier was one of our favorite things, because once you have one night with the band, you get a real good vibe for them. We didn't do any interviews with them the first night. We didn't hang out with them the first night. We just did our job and wanted to have a clue. And the bigger the band, the harder the mix. We were talking about live mix. When you have a big band like Ozo and you have so many people on the stage, everyone's got multiple instruments, doing that live, getting a mix of that, that is incredibly hard. So, you know, we did that through the Ozo and we got through the first night. And so the second night comes, they're hanging out with us before the show. And now we have a rapport with them. Now they know who we are. We've been hanging out for over 24 hours. We're not just some, you know, they're looking at us through the side of their eyes like, who are these people? And so then I got each member of the band to come in, do some separate interviews, and really hang out. And they spent time with us, and they hung out with us, and we got a rapport with them. And we did some fun interviews, and they really enjoyed us and really got to know us. And so they became our friends. And so we recorded them again another time later. That never aired yet, but you know, it's just one of those things where, you know, you dream about someone and then you get them. And then, you know, it takes that luster off where they're not some like, wow, it's Ozo Motley. Now they're just friends. It's Will Dog. It's, you know, it's Jiro, and we're hanging with them. Yeah. And they're our friends.
These guys are real guys. They're real guys, and they're having a hard journey on the road. And
exactly, on the bus. They're
exactly on the bus, and they're
the sardine can,
you know, rule number one, no number two, that kind of thing on the bus, you know what I'm saying?
And then, you know, and they're appreciative. That's the thing that it really to me makes it all worthwhile, is that when we get together with an artist and we feel like we're like in awe of them, and we're like, oh my God, we're with Steel Pulse or whatever, and we're totally freaking out and we're getting to do our thing, and then they are like, wow, thank you guys for what you do, because you're giving us a voice.
Exactly.
You're taking our music, instead of getting the one generic cut that the commercial radio plays over and over and over, you're giving us a whole hour, and you're talking to us, and you care about us, and you're giving our music out to people that don't get a chance to hear us, and they're appreciative.
I think we're appreciated, yes. I think we're appreciated.
What people don't realize is how much work it takes before you actually even get to a place and start recording.
Oh, God.
To actually get the rights to the material, to go through management, to get to the artist, to get back to management, to get back to you
even
guys.
After we record, we don't necessarily have the rights to air it.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, this is stuff that we could never explain to the listener, how much time and effort goes into each show. A generic thing that we figured out once was that it takes about 100 to 150 hours per show to actually produce it. And that's a lot of work for a little one-hour show that doesn't make any money.
That's why we call it the hardest working hour in radio.
The hardest working hour in radio.
That's
you
right.
Heard it, ladies and gentlemen.
The hardest working hour in radio, guaranteed. Nobody else can say that.
Hello, this is Raul from Ozo Motley. We're at the Paramount in Santa Fe on Southwest Stages. This one goes out to a very beautiful spirit who was always with me. This one goes out to Elena Dolores Pacheco, my mother.
Cuando canto mi canción, quiero inspirar.
despierto en la mañana, sé que tengo el poder para una día trompar. Hey, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah, yeah.
La, 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 hey, la, la,
hey, yeah, yeah.
La, 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 la.
Cuando me acuesto en la noche, puedo mirar estrellas que me dan esperanza.
This is Mike Koster with a big congratulations to Southwest Stages for their 100th episode of recording reggae, blues, folk, world music, all kinds of great stuff here on Southwest Stages. When I first heard about you guys, it was from recording festivals. You've come out and you've recorded My Festival Thirsty Year. You've recorded Globalkirky, the great world music festival in Albuquerque. You've recorded amazing artists at Telluride Blues and Brews, at Telluride Jazz. I'm not a big jazz fan, but I've heard some great stuff from Telluride Jazz that you guys have done. You go out and you record 30 artists at a festival. Tell us what happens then. You've got all this material. What happens?
Within a weekend, we can get a lot of material. And so it minimizes the work for us. And that's a key factor. I mean, because when you do a single show, like just going out and recording one show at one event, I mean, that's a lot of hours spent. And you come home and you get maybe one show out of it. If we're lucky, two shows, that's it. But you come out of a festival and you can get compilation shows, you can get genre shows, you can get evenings with you. I mean, the music lasts forever. And so when we come back with all that material, I mean, first of all, just listening to it, just trying to go through and see what actually came out good? What performances were great? What mixes did we not screw up? And then listening to it all and then deciding how to, you know, what we want to get to right away, what's going to come out next year before the festival, what can be saved for a genre thing. I mean, there's so much material that...
That's hundreds of hours, right?
Yeah,
there,
it's hundreds of hours, and it really truly is. And so the amount of work is incredible. But you know, we love our festivals. I mean, that's the thing I got to let you know is that it's a heck of a lot of work, and we're out there in the field, and it's 20-hour days, and we're just killing ourselves. But it's such a pleasure, and it's so much fun because each festival has its own feel, its own vibe, stories and events, things that go on behind the scenes that resonates with us for years, meeting artists, hanging out with them at multiple events. I mean, these are all things that we love, and sometimes we'll see the same artists at multiple festivals through multiple years. Alvin, Youngblood Heart, Sonny Landreth, they'll hit all they're on the festival tour that year, and we'll get three or four artists, you know, different recordings, so we'll be able to do a best of show with that artist.
Howdy, partners. This is Alvin Youngblood Heart, playing at the 2005 Thirsty Air Festival. You're listening to Southwest Stages.
All right, we're going to do a real oldie for you right now. A song from back around 1930 or somewhere there. About I wonder when I can get back home. Because I know it's the truth, man.
Thank you. See Mary Lambo. But you never forget the day I knock on your door.
Thank you, you're too kind. Thank you very much. Mr. Henry Butler, y'all.
Mr. Corey Harris.
Snout trying to keep my pit to bite your ass cheeks out. If you let a man kick you once, he can get you three times. I mean, he can get you three times. Well, if you let a man kick you once, he can get you three times. Let a man wanted to kick me once, I had to change his mind. Look here, baby, ain't got no clouds, ain't gonna put up with the none of your trust. Two, three times. Yeah, yeah.
Hello, this is Henry Butler, and I'm pulling my horse-drawn wagon on the dusty streets of Santa Fe, New Mexico, at the Thirsty Year Festival. I'm now standing here at the Eves Ranch, and you are listening to Southwest Stages.
I'm your special guest host, David House, and you're listening to part two of our special four-part series celebrating Southwest Stage's 100th show. Tonight's show is the second in our four-part series that gives you a behind-the-scenes look into the making of the Southwest Stage's radio program. Coming up later on the show, we'll feature music by Robert Cray, Coco Taylor, and Odetta. And listen in as our guest hosts, Mike Koster and Aija Umi, continue their conversation with the Southwest Stage's crew. So stay with us for the second half of the program for much more from our 100th show, coming up right after this.
Los queridos del pasado, mira cómo baila mi mamá, bailando con mi hermano del pasado. Su espíritu se junta bailando, y alegría y gozando.
Cumbia, cumbia,
pero qué buena cumbia, cumbia, pero qué rica cumbia,
cumbia,
pero qué mina cumbia, cumbia.
Southwest Stages would like to thank our broadcast partners. KRCC 91.5 FM in Colorado Springs, Colorado. KTEP 88.5 FM in El Paso, Texas. KCIE 90.5 FM in Dulce, New Mexico. KDUR 91.9 FM in Durango, Colorado. KSFR 90.7 FM in Santa Fe, New Mexico. And KRVS 88.7 FM in Lafayette, Louisiana.
You're listening to just a small sample of the incredible diversity of music right here on Southwest Stage's 100th show. Tune in. Thank you very much. I'm your host, John Strader.
You've recorded lots of blues. You've become friends with people like Corey Harris. You've recorded Honey Boy Edwards. You recorded Robert Cray, as I recall. Tell us about Robert Cray.
You know, Robert Cray was a huge coup for us because, you know, he's one of those artists that I found out after talking to his management that in the last 20 years that his manager had been with him, he'd only allowed three people to record him ever. That's huge. And he's one of those artists that doesn't have a manager that makes every decision for him. So everything comes to him. And so when we sent the stuff out, it went directly to Robert. He read over our materials and decided, I want to be part of this. But it was one of those things where it's like, I have to listen to the material afterwards and give you the rights after. So we have the right to record, but not necessarily to broadcast.
Where did you record him and when?
It was at the Telluride Blues and Brews. I think it was 2005. And so then we came home, and this was actually our very first remix that we ever did. After we came home with the Robert Cray, we were not really happy with the mix as well as it could be, so we took it into the computer, remixed the whole thing, sent it to him, he listened to it over Christmas, and then gave us the broadcast rights. So it's like, when you get an artist like that, who like, he listens to it himself, and artists are the most critical of anyone. I mean, a manager can listen to it and say, yeah, sounds fine, broadcast it. But the artists themselves, they're the most critical of their art. So for the artist to say, wow, that sounds good, I want you to air it, that's a big deal.
I'm about to lose it, my force of habit. I wanna see you burn all the way down.
ground, then I will know that I can't forget about my last regret. The price is too high for what you're giving, so I'll stop being a fool and go on living. One is not enough, two is too much for me, yeah. I wanna see you burn all the way down. I wanna see your ashes all over the ground. And I will know that I can't forget about my last regret. Suffering, no more sorrow. Live for today, I'll be here tomorrow. I wanna see you burn all the way down. I wanna see your ashes all over the ground. Forget about my last regret. No more suffering, no more sorrow. Live for today, I'll be here tomorrow. I regret.
The music of Robert Cray, featured on Southwest Stages during our second year of programming. I'm your special guest host, David House, and you're listening to part two of our special four-part series celebrating Southwest Stages' 100th show. Still to come on the show, we'll feature songs by two women who are music icons, Coco Taylor and Odetta. But right now, let's head back to the Southwest Stages studios as our guest hosts Mike Koster and Aija Umi continue their behind-the-scenes conversation with the Southwest Stages crew.
This is Aija, and you're listening to Southwest Stages 100th show.
You're talking about blues. I want to talk about some blues, too, because, you know, have been associated with reggae music, but I grew up here in America and,
sure.
You know, South, in the South, and so... You know, my roots are gospel and blues and soul and
Coco Taylor.
Jazz. And so, you know, I just want to talk about that special night we had with Coco Taylor.
Oh, Coco.
I mean, that was Off the Hook as well. I mean, Third World was there, Coco Taylor.
That's right.
Meeting Coco Taylor was one of the highlights of my life.
You know,
hearing her live, that was the first time I'd seen her, and getting to talk to her was just...
She's amazing. Yes. She's an amazing soul. And you're right about that. I mean, but once again, the behind the scenes things people never know is like, you know, all of our artists perform for free. We can't pay anybody. But Coco, she's like, well, you know, I'm happy to be on the show. You know, I'm happy to do it. But my band, they're all paid hired guns. She's like, they're going to want to be paid. So we had to pay Coco's band to even record them before we even had permission to even do it.
We paid ourselves, we paid
exactly.
Coco.
I'm like out of my own pocket. I'm like, how much am I going to pay these guys? I'm like, you've got to be kidding me. But I didn't want to go out there and record all these other bands. It was like Los Lonely Boys. It was all these crazy bands. And we don't get to record Coco. I'm like, no way. What? How much? You know? And so I had to pay her band of people I don't even know their names, you know? And
well it worth be, it. It well had
to
be, worth it.
It was cash, too. It's like, no, we want cash behind the scenes. I had to pay them. But it was worth it because,
it was,
you know,
a tip.
So we got to hang with Coco, and she was great. She was so sweet to us.
And
she was just so happy that people, you know, care. And you know, even though the Apollo wasn't packed, I mean, everyone that was in there was up and going wild. And I don't know how old she was. She's like over 80 years old. And I mean, she was just raging. I was like, that woman's got it.
This was the Palace Solari in Santa Fe, New Mexico.
How y'all doing out there? Are you digging the blues? Well, somebody said they wanted me to go down in the basement one more time. Do y'all mind if I go down in the basement? We're gonna do this one for everybody. You look out. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Everything gonna be all right. Oh, yeah. Woo! When I was a little girl, 12 years old, I couldn't do nothing to save my doggone soul. Mama told me the day I was grown, she said, sing the blues, child, sing it from now on. I'm a woman, oh yeah, I'm a woman, I'm a ball of fire. I'm a woman. I can sing the blues. I'm a woman. Change old and new. Spell W-O-M-A-N. Oh, yeah. That means I'm grown. And win. I'm a woman. Cut stone for the pain. I'm a woman. I'm a love maker. I'm a woman. You know I'm an earth shaker. We'll be right back.
I'm born down yonder behind the sun. I'm gonna do something for you that ain't never been done. Hold back the lightning with the palm of my hand. Shake hand with the devil, make him crawl in the sand. I'm a woman, oh yeah. I'm a woman, I'm a ball of fire. I'm a woman, make love to a crocodile. And sing the blues. I'm a woman. Change all the news.
This is Coco Taylor at the Palo Solari in Santa Fe, New Mexico. This is Southwest Stages. Check it out for good music and the blues.
But speaking of blues and like legends, I mean, yes. Like Koster has brought, you know, with Southwest Roots music so many over the years. I mean, for me, another one that I look back and it's like I have that same feeling like we were talking about Coco was Odetta. And we got Odetta several times. And
she's
we
a singular lady, isn't
she's
she?
She's amazing. And I mean, she just radiates like that godmother of the world thing. I mean, people just bow down. It's Odetta. You get out of the way. I mean, she trained Dylan and Ramblin' Jack. She was there for all of it. You know.
Let me say something. Let me interject something about Odetta. This is Mike Koster. Having presented her several times, this is a very interesting fact that I did not know. She's often called the queen of American folk music. Yep. And whenever a promoter get some material on her, you know, all the propaganda that comes in from the publicity agency. Queen of American folk music, queen of American folk music. Well, does that really mean anything? I found out last year that it actually does mean something. The person that dubbed her that is Martin Luther King.
Really?
And he dubbed her that on the March on Washington. The March on Washington, Dylan was there, Peter, Paul, and Mary, Odetta, Richie Havens, all these really interesting artists were there at a very important time in American history. And Odetta and Martin Luther King were very good friends. And he dubbed her on that day the queen of American folk music, and it stuck.
Wow.
And what's interesting about that is that Odetta is very interwoven with the civil rights movement. There was a soundtrack to the civil rights movement, a very important soundtrack to the civil rights movement, and Odetta was part of that soundtrack. And that is part of why when you see her on stage, she has such moral authority. There's such gravity to her on stage. You see her up there singing, and I've seen her in recent years. Sometimes she's been better than in past years in terms of the actual technical ability of her voice.
Sure.
But the moral authority every single year seems to be getting weightier and weightier. She is an amazing presence on stage, and that is because she is so interwoven with that history. She's absolutely astounding on stage, and she's not interested in just getting up there and singing a song.
No.
She's up there singing history. She's up there telling people every night, giving people every night a history lesson.
Yeah, living that dream of Martin Luther King, because that was one of the highlights also of speaking with Coco Taylor, was when I asked her if she had met Martin Luther King and how, you know, the importance for her of having met Dr. King, and that they had actually become friends through collaborating with events and the music. So, you know, and it's nice to hear that history of Odetta. I didn't know that.
We get this song from
Hughie Ledbetter, Lead Belly to you. It's called the Bourgeoisie Blues. Me and my wife run all over town. Everywhere we go, people would turn us down. It's a bourgeois town. A bourgeois town. Tell all the news, it's a bourgeois town. Come along, people. Listen to me. Don't try to find no home in Washington, D.C. It's a bourgeois town. It's a bourgeois town. Spread the news all around. Now me and Martha was standing upstairs. I heard a white man say, "We don't want no niggers up there. It's a bourgeois town. It's a bourgeois town. I'm gonna spread the news all around." I don't want no bourgeois turning me down. I live in a bourgeois town. A bourgeois town. In a bourgeois town, I'm gonna spread the news all around. Home of the brave, land of the free. I don't want to be mistreated by no bourgeois. It's a bourgeois town, spread the news all around. Tell all the colored folks, listen to me. Don't try to find no home in Washington, D.C. It's a bourgeois town. It's a bourgeois town. It's a bourgeois town, spread the news all around. Me and my wife run all over town. Everywhere we go, even colored folks turn us down. It's a bourgeois town. It's a bourgeois town. It's a bourgeois town. I'm gonna spread the news all around.
You've been listening to part two of our special four-part series celebrating Southwest Stage's 100th show. Southwest Stage's would like to thank the network of community and public radio stations who broadcast this program on a weekly basis. Southwest Stage's would like to thank the artists, festivals, music venues, promoters, volunteers, and our donors for all of their help and support during our first three seasons. We'd also like to thank some of the people who made this show possible. Thanks to the staff at the Rialto Theater in Tucson, Arizona. The staff and crew of the Telluride Blues and Brews Festival. The staff and crew of the Thirsty Ear Festival. The Paramount Nightclub. The Paolo Soleri Amphitheater. Southwest Roots Music. Fan Man Productions. And Santa Fe Audio Visual. We'd also like to take this time to thank our volunteer staff and crew. Thanks to producer and host John Strader. Technical director Chip Borton. Operations Manager, Nola Daves Moses. Board members, Daphne Strader and Gail Harvey. production support provided by Axel Corral, Adan Maldonado, and Jim Flynn. Special thanks to guest hosts Mike Koster, Aija Umi, and David House for all of their support over the years. Southwest Stage's program schedule, member stations, broadcast times, services, and contact information is available at southweststages.org. I'm your special guest host, David House. Thank you so much for listening. Tune in next week as we feature part three of our four-part series celebrating Southwest Stage's 100th show with music by Ralph Stanley, Doc Watson, Robert Earl Keen, Steve Earle, Ziggy Marley, Stephen Marley, and much more. Live events have a vibrant quality and spontaneity that can't be recreated in a studio. Southwest Stages is committed to advancing the art of live music. They've recorded hundreds of internationally renowned artists and are now available for on-site stereo and multi-track recordings wherever you play. They also offer CD duplication, mobile studio rental, event archiving, and live remote radio broadcasts. More information is at southweststages.org. Next time on Southwest Stages, help us celebrate our 100th show with the third program in our special four-part series, featuring guest hosts and a behind-the-scenes look at the making of Southwest Stages. Tune in next week for music by Ralph Stanley, Doc Watson, Robert Earl Keen, Steve Earle, Ziggy Marley, Stephen Marley, and much more. So listen in to Southwest Stages next time as we continue to celebrate our 100th show.